People's Church family and all our friends online who join us week after week for our Sunday services. It's such a joy to have you join us even today as we come to the second Sunday of the new year. Let me ask you a question. What challenges are you facing in your life today? Maybe in your family, maybe in your job. Or what are your hopes for 2021? Well, let me tell you that as you go through this service, just trust God to speak to you, to encourage you, to give you new hope, and to give you something that you can carry with you for the rest of the week. God loves you and He wants to bless your life in 2021. So as we join in worship today, I want you to reflect on the inspirational lyrics of these songs. Worship God together with our worship team and be renewed in your faith and in hope as you sing along with our worship team. I will hand over now to our worship team to lead you to the throne of grace.
Let's sing this out. At your name, at your name, the mountains shake and crumble. At your name, the oceans roar and tumble. At your name, the angels will.
We praise you and worship you, Lord, this morning. We exalt you, Lord, for there is no one like you. No one like you, O God.
Bring hope, you rest. that again. You give life. You give life. You are love. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope. You restore every heart that is broken. So great.
Sing, great.
Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Praise you. We exalt you. We glorify your name. We praise your holy name. Hallelujah. What a joy it is, friends, to be able to sing these songs of praise and worship unto our Lord. Those lyrics inspire us to believe God for great things and to truly worship Him for who He is. So thank you for joining us in worship, and my thanks to the worship team as well. I would like to take a moment to pray for you right now and to pray for your needs, for your challenges, whatever struggles you're facing right now, and to pray God's blessing upon you in 2021. You know, in the Bible, it is said that God crowns the year with His goodness. So let that be your hope as we pray right now. Whatever burden you have, lift it up to the Lord. Ask the Lord for His help and join together with me as we pray. And I know the Lord can answer the cry of your heart. Shall we pray? Loving Heavenly Father, I want to pray for everyone who has joined us today on this service, Lord. Lord, as we look at this year, there's a lot of uncertainty, Lord. People are worried about health matters, about finances, about other struggles, Lord. Some people are kept confined to their homes, and they may be wondering what the year holds for them, Lord. But, oh God, we thank you because you are the God who has promised that you will never leave us. You will never forsake us. You are the God who has promised to bring restoration into our lives and to give us favor. Therefore, Lord, I would like to pray for everyone who is part of this service today. Lord, whatever challenges they have, may their favor and the blessing of God rest upon their lives and their families, I pray, Lord. I pray that what they have lost in the past year, Lord, you will begin to restore back into their lives, O God. I pray that you would give favor, Lord, upon every work of their hand. Lord, what they plan to do, that you will give them wisdom, grace and strength, O God, and open doors, Lord, to succeed in whatever they want to do. Lord, I pray that they will lack nothing, Lord, that they need in the year that is ahead, O God. And Lord, that you will carry them through week by week, month by month, Lord. Bless every individual. Bless their families. Bless their children. Give them new hope for 2021, O God. And I pray that they will see the goodness and the favor of God in powerful ways with signs of your favor upon their life, Lord. Be with them, I pray, and make their plans to succeed for your glory. In Jesus' name I pray, Lord. Amen. 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 Lord, I also want to pray healing for anyone who may be looking to you for healing today. Stretch forth your mighty hand, Lord. In the name of Jesus, I pray that you would bring healing into their hearts and to their bodies, O God, and even to their minds, Lord, if they are having emotional disturbances in their life today, Lord. I pray healing in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. Praise God. He is a God who hears and answers prayer. In the Bible, God has said, "Call upon me in the day of trouble, and I will answer."
Dear church family, I have some wonderful news for you. From next Sunday, the 17th of January 2021, we are starting our live services here at Narayanpeta. I would like to remind you, if you have already registered and you have your registration card or your QR code on your phone, please do bring it along. We also need to continue to keep following the health guidelines and regulations set out for us by the Ministry of Health and the health authorities. Please do pay attention to this short video.
Hello, People's Church family. A warm welcome to you. Please take a minute to watch this video as we share with you the health guidelines for those attending services. If you are having a fever, a cough, or a cold, please refrain from attending the service and join us on RTV, Facebook, or YouTube. As you enter the church premises, please take a moment to read the notice boards. All vehicles will be checked upon arrival. It is mandatory to wear a mask as you enter the premises. All attendees will be provided with hand sanitizer as they pass through contactless security and temperature checks. If your temperature is above average, one of our helpers will direct you to our medical tent where a secondary assessment will be made. If you have not registered as yet, please do so on the link shown on your screen. Alternatively, you can register at the registration desk on your arrival, for which we request you to bring your own pen. It is advisable that you come 20 minutes before your service time. The entrances to the main sanctuary, all registration cards will be scanned. If you are having difficulty scanning your card, please walk over to the nearest help desk where one of our helpers will be happy to assist you. Thank you for your attention. We look forward to worshiping with you at People's Church.
Right now, it's my joy to hand over to Pastor Dishan Vikramaratna, the senior pastor of our church, as he continues our series for the new year. It's titled, How to be Happy in 2021. So maybe you can smile right now to go with the theme. And this is the second in our series for the new year. So let me hand over to Pastor Dishan Vikramaratna. May the sermon bless you today as he ministers.
You know, on the 31st of December at our watch night service, I talked to you about our theme for 2021. Our theme for 2021 is Obey Your Call. Each one has a call. We believe that every one of you has a specific call from God as He made you unique for His plan and purpose. after a year where the whole world has been flattened by COVID-19, and I guess we've all had a reality check, you know, that check has been imposed on us by the Lord with regards to our values. You need to take heed and obey your call. The Lord has called you to do your part and touch your world. So, He wants you to stop dodging your call and to obey your call. I say all this because next week, I will take a break from our current series on how to be happy in 2021, because I want to talk to you again on what I spoke at the 31st Watch Night service about obeying your call. So please make a note of that and don't miss it. Let's pray and ask God's blessing on His word for today. Father, thank you for the privilege of sharing your word again. And thank you for speaking to all of us through your word. Let Dishan decrease. Let the Holy Spirit increase. Lord, let your will be done in all of our lives and change us according to your word. In Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen and amen. Now, we're in a series called How to Be Happy in 2021, which is on the 8 keys to happiness that Jesus gave in his great sermon called the Sermon on the Mount. This is found in Matthew chapter 5, 6 and 7. Now, last week we looked at Matthew 5 verse 3. Matthew 5, 3 says, "Blessed are the poor in spirit," or "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven." You see, your first step to happiness is learn to be humble. Learn to be humble. You see, we also learn that the word blessed, the Greek root word, comes and it means supremely happy. Blessed means supremely happy. So that's why we're saying how to be happy, right, in 2021. Today, we're going to look at the second one, and that is how to heal a broken heart. Today's theme is how to heal a broken heart. Now, Jesus teaches us today how to be happy in spite of our circumstances. Let me ask you this. How many of you can remember your first broken heart? Maybe girlfriend or boyfriend, or maybe it was the loss of a loved one, or maybe divorce of parents, or you were dropped from the team at school, or whatever. You see, the Bible never tries to explain suffering. But what it does is, it teaches us how to handle it. How to handle it. Jesus said in Matthew 5, 4, "Happy are those who mourn, for they will be comforted." How can I be happy after a loss? It almost looks like a contradiction. After a broken heart, how can I be happy? By receiving the comfort of God. I hope you got that. Right? How are you happy in these situations? By receiving the comfort of God. Today I want to give you three ways how you can experience the comfort of God. The first one is realize that God is with you. Realize that God is with you. When we are hurting, we forget where God is. We think He seems distant or that He doesn't care. But the fact is, He is there. Look at Psalm 34:18. Psalm 34:18. "The Lord is close to the brokenhearted. He rescues those whose spirits are crushed." God is with you in your pain. You need to remember these things, you see, when you are in pain, like Job 13:27 says, "You keep a close watch on all my paths." You see, God is watching over you. Nothing escapes His eye. The Bible says, "Your very tears, every tear you cried, is numbered." Some of you say, "Oh, nobody knows what I'm going through." God knows, and God is aware of you. You see, we have a sympathetic Heavenly Father who really, really, really cares. Your pain matters to God. It really does. You can talk to Him about your hurt. In the book of Hebrews, chapter 4 and verse 16, it says, "So let us come boldly to the throne of our gracious God. There we will receive His mercy and we will find grace to help us when we need it most." You know, God is not only with us, He wants to assist and help us. God not only cares about your hurt, He wants to help you with your hurt. Some people, you know, grow through their pain, and some people get stuck in their pain and their hurt, and they can never get past it. Why? Because they never take the next step, the second step. Step one, realize that God is with you. But how do you get out of the pain and get on with life? Well, step two, let's look at number two. Release the hurt. Release the hurt. Let it go. How? You must stop focusing on what's lost and start focusing on what's left. Isaiah 43, verses 18 and 19 say this: Forget the former things, do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. You see, this is a clear prophecy to someone right now, directly from God's word. God says, your past is past. Let it go. It can't hurt you anymore. Some of you are letting other people from your past continue to hurt you. I want to tell you, that's dumb. They can't hurt you unless you let them. That's a choice that you make. Friend, let it go. Release the hurt and realize that God is with you. He's your healer. He will see you through. You know, here are some options what you can do with your hurt. Some of these options that you do are wrong, right? The first one is repress it. Repress your hurt. Push it down. You know, swallow it up. If you swallow your feeling, you know what's going to happen? Your stomach is going to keep score. You may need a lot of antacids, right? If you pretend it doesn't exist and you hold it in, that's unhealthy. I meet walking wounded people all of the time because they never let go of their past hurts. They keep repressing it and they hurt those around them that love them the most because they are repressing their hurt. Then the second thing is, you rehearse it, right? You rehearse it. What do I mean by that? They go over and over and over again, this one hurt in their minds. They torture themselves by thinking about it over and over. God says, don't dwell on the past. That's what we just read. Don't let it consume your thoughts. There's a big difference between mourning and moaning, right? Now, mourning is legitimate grief. We mourn because a loss of somebody. Jesus said in Matthew 5:4, happy are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. God wants to comfort you in your grief and your heartache. There's a difference again between mourning and moaning or moping, right? Mourning, right, is, oh, poor me, poor me. And you want to keep a hold of that self-pity party feeling. God says you don't repress it and you don't rehearse it. Then what is the thing that you should do? You do the third thing, which is release it. Release it. The best option is release the hurt to God. What does that mean? Let's look at Romans 12:19. Romans 12:19 says, dear friends, never take revenge. Leave that to the righteous anger of God. For the scripture says, I will take revenge. I will pay them back, says the Lord. Now, aren't you glad that that verse is in the Bible? If you want to let go of your hurt, you must let God settle the score. If somebody has hurt you, let God handle it. Who do you think could do a better job at getting even? Friend, listen to me. Resentment eats you up. It kills you from inside. It's like cancer. It eats you alive and it destroys you. The hurts that hurt the most are those that are out of our control. Someone did something to us that we couldn't control and they hurt us and it's out of our control. But remember, it's not out of God's control. Give it to God. Give it to Him. You know, if you're mourning and in grief and hurting today, remember that God is with you. God is with you. He's close to you. He's close to the brokenhearted, the Bible says. If you're in mourning today, if you're hurting today, God has never been closer to you. Realize that He cares and He wants to help you. Give Him the hurt. Release it to Him. Don't dwell on the past. Release it to God. Let Him have it. The third thing I want to bring to you today is rely on God's resources. Rely on God's resources. You see, rely on God's resources. Why? Because it's those resources that are given to comfort you. Let's read Matthew 5:4 again. He says, "Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted." How can I be happy in the midst of trials and tragedy? I want to tell you, it's by receiving God's comfort. It's amazing what some people will try to do just to be comforted. You know, they'll take to pills, they will get drunk, some will have affairs, get in and out of bed with different people. Some people watch TV all the time. Some people read and fantasize the novels that they read. Some people sleep all the time, all trying to get rid of all the pain in their life. But God says, don't do those things. They are just quick fixes. They don't last. What are the comforters that God uses? I want you to listen to this carefully. Three things God uses to comfort you. The first one is God's word. God's word. Fill your mind with God's word. David, King David says in Psalm 119 verse 25, "I lie in the dust. Revive me by your word." And then again in the same psalm, further down in verse 52, Psalm 119, 52, he says, "I meditate on your age-old regulations, O Lord, they comfort me." You know, I'm telling you, read through the book of Psalms and take a highlighter or a pencil and highlight all the verses that comfort you. You know, the Psalms was written to comfort us. Friend, listen to me again. I say this many times. There are over 7,000 promises in the Bible. Underline them, claim them. God has never broken even one promise yet. You know, I know that today, many of you listening to me, I know a lot of hidden hurt. You know, behind your pretty or handsome faces, there's a lot of pain. You're saying, you know, does God have a word for me today? The answer is yes, He does. He has a word for you right now. The word is, your pain matters to God. He sees it. He understands it. He feels it. He'll help you in that frustration. He'll help you through that pain and that hurt. Look to God's word. Friend, listen to me. I know sometimes man gives words. You know, we give words of knowledge. We give prophecies. And those are good. They're there. But nothing can be compared to the unadulterated word of God. When God speaks and reveals to you directly, He speaks through His word. That's why sometimes we run after man, because we got a word and they said the thing that we wanted to hear. And God uses man, but never like the word of God that He speaks directly through you. But the problem is we don't get into the word. Look to the word, right? God uses His word. Secondly, what are the comforters that God uses? God uses His people. God's people. We need each other. We were not made to be isolated from each other. There is no such thing as a lone ranger Christian. We need each other to make it. If you don't have any family, I want to tell you today, we are your family. People's Church is a family. You know, that's what God meant the church to be. You need to be in a family. You need to be in a small group so you can have those people to encourage you in tough times and be there. If you're not sure, call the prayer line and say, "I want to get involved with a small group." Maybe right now it's on Zoom, or "I want to meet wherever it's possible." But get into somebody. If you don't have any other place, get in. You need it. Ecclesiastes 4 verses 9 and 10. Ecclesiastes 4, 9 and 10. What does it say? Two people are better off than one, for they can help each other succeed. If one person falls, the other can reach out and help. But someone who falls alone is in real trouble. You know, for those hurting today, I want to tell you, you're not alone in your hurt. You think your problem is unique. That is not true. No matter what problem you have, it is not unique. Hundreds, thousands, maybe even millions of people over the history of humanity have had the very same problem you have right now. The chance is that there are people who have gone through what you are going through. You just need to open up and share where you're hurting so they can stand with you and help you out. God uses His word, but God uses people. He uses His people. If you don't have anyone to comfort you and pray for you, you know, I want you to please call the prayer line on your screen. Call it and someone will be there waiting to pray for you. In 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 3 and 4, 2 Corinthians 1, 3 and 4, the God of all comfort comforts us in all our troubles so that we can comfort others with the comfort we ourselves have received from God. People in pain don't need advice. They just need someone to say, yes, I understand. I know what it is like to have a child die. Or I know what it is like to go through a divorce. Or yes, I know what it's like to lose your job overnight. I know what it is like to miss a goal or a dream. My friend, God never wastes a hurt. If you have had a problem in your life that you have gone through, you know what? You have an obligation to other people to help them through their problem. That's your ministry. God wants to use the hurts you've had in your life to encourage others. Whether you learned anything or not, just the very fact that you can say, oh yes, I understand. I know where you're coming from. I remember the loneliness. I remember the pain. I will never forget the rejection. I remember what it felt like to be brought up in the home of an alcoholic father. Or you say, I know what it's like to be brought up where my mother walked out the door and never came back. There are people going through that very experience right now. Friend, they need your comfort. They need your help. You know, stop looking only your way and start looking at them. Because God put you so you can touch others. And I'll also tell you, when you touch others, you will be touched. Happiness will come to your life like never before because you learned how to give out of your pain. The last comforter that God uses, He uses the word, He uses other people, but very importantly, right, one of the comforters that God uses is God's Spirit. God's Spirit. This is the greatest comfort of all. God Himself wants to be your friend. You know, 2,000 years ago, Jesus walked around in a physical body like us here on earth and said to His disciples in John 14, 16, in John 14, 16, He said, I'm going to go back to heaven. And when I go, I'm going to ask the Father to send you another comforter. You know, there are many words that have been used here, right? And these words are, I'm going to send you another counselor. I'm going to send you another comforter. I'm going to send you another helper, send you a friend. All these words used equals comforter. He's the Holy Spirit of God. That's who the comforter is. God's Holy Spirit. You know, one of the jobs of the Holy Spirit is to comfort us. When I invited Jesus Christ into my life, I was not trying to join a religion or get into a church. No, I invited Him to come into my life and I committed my life to Him. You know what happened when I did that? You know, I said, Lord, I want to get to know You better. Because it's not about trying to follow a philosophy or some type of religion. No, it was trying to get into a relationship with God. I want to tell you, it doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter whatever background, religious or ethnic you come from. I am talking to you about a relationship with God Almighty. As a pastor, I walked with a lot of people through a lot of grief. Psychologists see emotional pain. You know, doctors see the physical pain. Bankers may see financial pain and, you know, different types of pains. But we pastors, you know, we tend to see a little bit of everything. I deal with people in financial pain, relational pain, physical pain, emotional pain, marriage pain, even parenting pain. The saddest part of life actually is when you are at a funeral and you watch people trying to deal with their sorrow and pain. As to those who don't know Christ and haven't secured eternal life, I want to tell you, listen to me. I'm talking about God and you and nothing in between. If you haven't secured a relationship with God and eternal life, there is no comfort. It breaks my heart to see people at a funeral, you know, trying to cheer each other up and trying to get each other up with nothing. There is no hope. But today I want you to know there is hope for you. You know, listen to this real life story of pain, brokenness and depression, and how the hope of the Comforter comes through.
Hi, I'm Savi, and the experience I'm about to share happened many decades ago. Age and time, and most certainly the grace of God, has made it all a distant memory. In the prime of my youth, in my mid-20s, a series of events had led me to a deep depression. I had to seek medical help in the services of a psychiatrist and was on medication until I came through that dark tunnel. It was a humbling experience. My beloved parents were the ones who picked up the pieces and helped me through this trial. I'm grateful to them and also to my church family who were praying for me faithfully. The thing I remember most was the difficulty of sleeplessness. It was a struggle to fall asleep. When I took the prescribed medication, I feared that I would be dependent on them for life. When morning dawned, getting up and out of bed was another battle. There was no purpose or meaning each day. Life held no joy for me. Books, nor movies, nor hobbies had any pleasure for me. I became a recluse. My mind was always filled with anxious and rambling thoughts. It was just like a ticking clock all the time. Before the onset of my depression, I had stuck a verse from the Bible in my room. Despite all the confusion and muddled head that I had, this verse kept coming to mind. The verse was, "The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit." Elsewhere in the Bible, God is described as a repairer of broken walls. Despite how I felt, deep down in my heart, I knew God was building my walls brick by brick. After almost a year of gradual recovery, I was re-employed and was able to complete some study that I had begun, but which was interrupted for a period. God also opened my eyes to the importance of eating healthy, doing some form of exercise, finding some downtime, and the value of family and friends. As time went by, I was married to my wonderful husband, and we were blessed with two lovely children. All of this didn't seem like a reality then, when I was stuck in middle gear, as it were, in the thick of things. As a family, we've crossed many rivers, and God has journeyed with us all the way. We don't know what tomorrow holds, but we do know who holds our tomorrow, and we do know that He holds our hands. When all hope is lost and darkness seems to surround you, hold on to the promises of God. Jesus will never fail you. What He's done for me, He can do much more for you.
This is what God can do. You know, I can't do much, but God can do anything for you. Today, Savi and Rajin Seneviratna are in New Zealand and are serving and touching people. You know why? Because of what God has done in their lives. The Word of God says that when Jesus Christ comes into our life, we have a hope. In Revelation 21, verse 4, it says, Revelation 21, 4, "He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there will be no more death or sorrow or crying or pain. All these things are gone forever." It says that someday in heaven, for believers, there will be a place of no pain, no more sorrow, no more suffering, no more grief, no anger, no more resentment, no more being victims. You know, I'm looking forward to that day. I'm not trying to scare you into heaven. I invite you to invite Jesus Christ into your life. Not because you're going to die tonight, because you're probably not going to, but because you got to live tomorrow and you need Him in your life. If you have never given God an opportunity to come into your life, forgive your sins, be the Lord of your life and bring peace and joy and eternal life, bow your heads, close your eyes, don't look around. Reverence this moment and pray this prayer with me, but mean it from your heart and God will honor your prayer. Say, dear Lord Jesus, I come to you now. I need you in my life. Please forgive me of all my sin. Wash me with the blood that you shed on Calvary. Cleanse my mind. Cleanse my heart. Cleanse my whole being. I open my heart to you. Come and be the Lord of my life. Take charge. I give my life to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. You know, if you prayed that prayer sincerely, like I said, there is no magic in this. There is no lightning and thunder. It's a simple prayer of faith. God heard your prayer. I'm telling you, you're not alone. He's in you. He will walk with you. It's not what you do, it's what He has already done for you. There are some of you, you know, you're a short way away from collapse. This corona business has, and shutdowns have, you know, caused so much of pain and hurt in your life. You're barely able to hold back the tears. I want to say to you, God cares and your pain matters to God. He is aware of the frustration in your life. He is aware of the hurt, the guilt, the anger, the resentment, the fear, and even the depression. He says, I want to help you out. Trust in me. Close your eyes. Take one hand and put it on your heart. Raise your other hand to heaven, but believe in your heart. Father, I bring my brother, my sister, I bring everyone listening to me right now. Lord, we pray to you, God Almighty. Lord, you see the hurt, you see the pain, you see what people are going through. I pray in Jesus' name that right now you will touch every heart. Lord, you will heal broken hearts. You will wipe away tears. Peace and joy will come in and be their portion. And you will lift them up, Lord, because you are the God who cares about those who hurt, who are mourning. Lord, and I pray right now in Jesus' name that your presence will be their portion. Rule and reign in each one's life. Bring healing where healing is needed. I pray for those sick that healing virtue will flow. Financial situations and relationship issues, Lord, whatever it may be, fear of the future, Lord, about marriage, in Jesus' name, and relationship with children, in Jesus' name, we commit it all to you. Give it to God now. Give it to Him. Lord, we give it to you and we free ourselves as you will take it over and do what is needed. Thank you for hearing our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.
There is coming a day when no heartache shall come, no more clouds in the sky, no more tears to dim the eye. All is peace. Show.
God bless you today as we prepare to close, and I pray that through this week God will keep his precious hand upon you and lead you to the best that he has for your life. By the way, the announcements of what we have planned for the rest of this week will be on the screen soon after this service, so please do watch them and take note and be a part of the activities that we are part of as People's Church. God bless you and have a blessed week in Christ.